Pre-COVID, Cairns' foaming fury whitewater rafting was teeming with overseas tourists.
We were rolling along nicely. We had an opportunity to buy our largest competitor, put on around 50 to 60 staff members, and things were sort of going along okay.
18 months later, and Roderick Rees isn't sure how much longer he can stay afloat.
It had an absolutely catastrophic effect for the industry up here. We were sort of trading around 10% of pre-COVID turnover. We've gone from 98 staff members down to 35.
He's one of many tourism businesses now at breaking point. New research today showing one in three are unlikely to make it to Christmas. This week, it's been made clear the biggest customers won't be back anytime soon.
We will get to international visitors as well, I believe, next year. But the priority is Australians. We're ready for takeoff.
That's an unacceptable outcome for the tourism industry. If we're not getting international tourists in, how is the tourism industry supposed to survive?
With domestic borders still closed, there's also zero confidence local tourists will be able to help make up for the shortfall.
We will open when it's safe to do so.
We have no clarity from our state government about where our exit strategy is. How can we go on when people from Sydney and Melbourne, our key markets, are travelling overseas and not coming up to Cairns?
Industry experts estimate the hit to the economy is a whopping $4 billion a month. There are a range of limited support measures provided by states and territories, but many in the industry are calling for an urgent JobKeeper-style subsidy to stop a wholesale collapse.
If a wage subsidy is falling on deaf ears, then so be it. The most helpful thing to the tourism industry is to help us hold on to our specialised staff.
So, will tourism be thrown a life raft, or will it be sink or swim?
Margie Osmond from the Tourism and Transport Forum is behind this worrying new research, and she joins us now. Margie, it's going to be months before international tourists are allowed back. Can these businesses hold on that long, do you think?
Look, and I think that's the guts of this research, essentially, that while lots of other parts of the economy are doing quite nicely and jobs are booming, the tourism industry is still hanging on by its fingernails, just. And about a third of the businesses we've spoken to said they'll be gone before Christmas.
Margie, can you understand why most Aussies who are desperate for a holiday, myself included, can you understand why we don't want to book anything interstate right now?
Absolutely, I can understand that. You know, the uncertainty around, will the border open? More importantly, will it close? Will I have to go through the process of getting a refund? How is this all going to work? And what am I going to do when I have to tell the kids we're not going on holiday to the Gold Coast after all? So, yes, I do understand it. And I think rebuilding that confidence in the traveller is going to be one of the most critical things for the industry.
So do you think states like WA and Queensland, the state governments, are actually doing harm to their own local businesses?
Look, the tourism industry has been 100% behind governments making good decisions for the right health reasons since the beginning of the pandemic. I suppose the issue for us now is that when vaccination rates reach 70% or 80%, we need some certainty that that's when borders will actually open. Because it's not just about the domestic situation. From an international point of view, A, you're not coming all the way to Australia if you've got a quarantine. But in addition to that, lovely as Sydney is, if you're coming here, you want to be able to go to the Great Barrier Reef and Uluru and Mingaloo and the Barossa Valley and everywhere else. So I suppose the issue here is set a line in the sand. The industry needs to know what it's planning for and when, as far as possible. At the moment, they still don't know, and it's that uncertainty which is leading so many of them to say, right, that's it, I'm done.
So, Margie, you're saying, as I have for many years, we need dates.
We need dates. We need dates. I know I do. Yes, definitely.
Well, Margie, so many people have already left the industry. Tourism's been suffering for a long time and it's been called a lost generation of experience. What are the implications of that?
Well, this is massive. This is a huge structural impact on the industry. We would normally have about 1.1 million direct and indirect jobs. We're projecting at the moment that we've probably lost something like 600,000. And they're not just sitting at home twiddling their thumbs. They're gone. They've gone to other industries and they're not coming back. So you've got situations where hotels can only open 30 to 40% because that's all the staff they can get. Dive boat operators up on the Great Barrier Reef, they're losing their experts and they're not coming back. It's that structural damage that is also going to take so long to fix.
OK, well, I think your message is clear. It's my civic duty to book as many holidays as possible in the next 12 months.
You are a good woman. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Margie.
And a whole lot of dates as well, right?
A whole lot of dates. I've got to do it.
A whole lot of dates. Right. As many as possible.
Thanks so much for your time and for your energy and passion for the tourism industry as well, Margie.
Thank you.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The Project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.